All right, y'all, what's up, guys? Thank you for tuning in to my channel, Gigi's Reality, where reality ends in TEA. I'm your girl, Gigi, and we're gonna do a TV review of the Beverly Hills Housewives. Granted, I might be of the melanin sisters. I do love a good rich white woman bougie shade. It's just something totally different from the typical, you know, Housewives of Atlanta, you know, Housewives of Potomac. These, like, bougie white women just throw shade, like, totally different, and it's like, it's a sport, actually, to do it the way they do it. This season, for sure, is going to be hella entertaining because it's the season of the Lisa Vanderpump downfall. Her reign has finally ended. If you are a Beverly Hills Housewives watcher, you actually might be of the whole world that has been waiting for this to happen. Because previous seasons, Lisa has just been very good at controlling everything, throwing the rock and hiding the hand, as I like to put it. But this season, it is finally over. She has fallen to the bottom of the totem pole. But we'll talk about that later on. So this episode opens up with Denise Richards and her fine-ass husband, Andrew, opening up gifts, talking about postponing the honeymoon because of her kids and their schedule. We finally have somebody give a Mauricio a run for his money. Mauricio is that, like, James Bond suit and tie type fine. And you know he got that coin because he got the agency real estate business. So you know he makes millions on the regular. But Andrew is that, like, wolf, 50 Shades of Grey type fine that you have, like, hot sex in the parking lot with. And I got a preference, and I'm leaning more towards Andrew. And for obvious reasons, if you watch, Denise Richards has put it out that Andrew is working with a little bit of something-something. Now, it's nice to know, but honey, rule number one, don't be letting these hoes know what your man is working with. Now that the streets know that your husband is packing, you better have chicken heads lined outside this man's place of business trying to get touched with his holistic healing hands, getting healed in more ways than one. Because 9 times out of 10, the only thing that's in Beverly Hills is rich white women that got the money and the husband that's rich, but he be gone 37 weeks out of the year with his assistant that he's most likely screwing. So she lonely, and the only thing she got left to do is walk her dog and go to yoga. And instead of yoga, now they about to be heading to Andrew's place of business, because hoes these days is ruthless and they do not mind that a man got a ring on his finger as long as it's getting them pleased. Now, Denise, you better start doing some drive-bys. You've already had to deal with it with Charlie Sheen and his ass burning everybody in between their legs because he don't know how to put a condom on. You better start checking these hoes, start doing random pull-ups, start doing drive-bys, because ain't nothing worse than having to live in a marriage where you got to take antibiotics every other week just to be sure you ain't getting burned. Okay, Denise, I warned you. Start doing some drive-bys and some random pull-ups. Don't let Andrew have any of these hoes feeling like they can rub and touch up all up on him. Check them hoes at the door. The next scene is Lisa Vanderpump at the Vanderpump Dog Center, and she's doing an interview basically talking about what her plans are with the fundraiser and her whole plan to stop the whole dog meat trade. Granted, I'm not a huge fan of Lisa Vanderpump. I do, you know, commend her efforts. I'm a pet person. You know, I definitely believe in animal rights. She has been fighting for, you know, dogs and pets and everything for a while. And I'm definitely on that train of the few trains I can get behind Lisa on. You know, I will follow her when it comes to this. She has a dude named Alcee Hastings. He's like a councilman or a governor or something that's on the board. And he's the one bringing up the proposition to the court. And they're waiting to see if it gets passed this episode for stopping the dog meat trade. So after her interview, she's kind of talking with her workers about how the whole drama has now, you know, passed out all around the girls and everybody's talking about it. She wants to call Teddy a bitch, but really, what did you expect to happen, Lisa? You put her in a situation and Teddy wasn't going to go down without swinging. Teddy is still doing the fundraiser in this episode for Vanderpump Dogs. They're both kind of putting their grievances with each other aside, you know, for a greater cause. You know, you got to do the grown woman thing when there's a bigger picture, you know, in play. Teddy has like a little cycling building that they did the fundraiser at. Everybody bought a bike and all the proceeds would go to Vanderpump Dogs for the pets. That's cool. And then everybody shows up to the fundraiser and everybody's wondering, okay, is Vanderpump going to show up? Obviously not, because let's get real. Vanderpump knows how to dish it, but she can't take it. She doesn't know how to stand in the line of fire when it comes to you know, taking on what she put out there. She doesn't know how to take responsibility and, you know, take what comes with it. She can do the dirt, but she can't handle the consequences of the dirt that she do. She tried to put Teddy out there and get her to go against Dorit because Vanderpump had her problems with Dorit, but it completely backfired on her, and now she is getting kicked off Gilligan's Island, basically. So the fundraiser goes good. I laugh when they get that compilation of Lisa Rinna with the like alcohol wipe going down and everything, and in the hotel room. I'm not gonna lie, the older I get, I've kind of become a germaphobe myself. Like, I'm guilty of keeping that Germex and Purell heavy around when I'm, you know, done touching stuff. I don't know why, but I just have. So that was pretty funny. You know, the ladies get done and they decide to go to lunch. Now, Vanderpump, she was throwing like a little shindig at the Vanderpump dogs to watch the casting or the, you know, preview of the whole court situation. And she could have went to the lunch, but she didn't, obviously, for, you know, for obvious reasons. And she stayed there, and luckily the bill got passed, so the dog meat trade will be getting ended. I am, you know, glad about that. I'm not going to knock Lisa for putting those efforts out there. But you can definitely tell she was going after John Blizzard. She has so many digs for him, talking about, you can go scrape up the poop now. Like, that's the thing that Lisa does. When she's dissatisfied with you, when the queen doesn't like you anymore, she's going to treat you like a peasant, tell you to sit at the end of the table and eat the scraps. And John Blizzard was getting all the jabs. Because, you know, she knew basically that he had told Teddy everything. And so at the lunch, everybody's talking about the whole press leak that happened to Dorit. Somewhere along the lines, a story leaked about the dog situation. If you haven't seen, Dorit adopted a dog from Vanderpump Dogs. And it was going good until the puppy started nipping at her kids and at PK. She knew a lady that liked her, and Dorit decided to give it to her. Dorit, I'm not going to blame Dorit in this situation at all. She thought she was giving the dog a good home when she handed it to the lady. And once she passes it off, it's no longer her responsibility. I guess the lady didn't want it anymore, and so she just took it to a random shelter. But all Vanderpump's dogs are chipped, so they ran the chip, and it came up in Lisa's system. And so Lisa and her workers, or one of her workers, had to go pick up the dog. Lisa wasn't satisfied with that. She goes and calls Dorit, and now it's a whole situation. Vanderpump really blew this out of proportion. Like, your friend just couldn't deal with the dog anymore. There's nothing wrong with that. But you keep punishing her for something that, like, wasn't even that big of a deal. Like, you got the dog back. The dog wasn't harmed. Like, what are you mad at her for? But she keeps pushing it out there. So at the table, they all basically talk about the wording, how it got out there. If there's only a handful of people that know, and majority of the people that know Vanderpump is in your circle, it's very obvious that it came from you, because it didn't come from Teddy and it didn't come from Dorit. By process of elimination, I'm sorry, Lisa, you gotta get got. Teddy wasn't playing them games with Lisa, because she knew as soon as she went to Vanderpump Dogs, basically Teddy was supposed to kind of put out there, oh, is this Dorit's pet? But when she got there, Lisa was kind of like, oh, don't talk about it, don't talk about it. And at that moment, Teddy knew, I've been set up. Lisa Vanderpump was very good. She knew to use Teddy because they hadn't got along in the past season. And what was going to happen was Dorit was going to blame it all on Teddy if the story got out there, because they had been going at each other. They had this beef. So Lisa Vanderpump was just going to stand from the sidelines and watch them go at each other. But Teddy didn't have it, and I'm glad somebody finally caught it, because in the past, Vanderpump always seems to get away with her hands clean, but not this time. The ladies started talking to Kyle, like, Kyle, when is this going to stop? You need to hold your friend accountable. And Kyle is in a tough spot, because if Lisa's her best friend, like, what do you do when your best friend does something wrong? Like, if you're a real friend, you'll tell them, like, it's wrong. Because it's basically about being right or wrong in this situation. It's not about if she's your friend or not. Because a real friend is going to tell you, like, look, you fucked up and you need to fix it. But it's going to be hard for her to do that, because nobody wants to go against Lisa, because she has pull in Beverly Hills. She knows everybody. Everybody knows her. You know, she feels like she can do, you know, pretty much run everything in that city. And she kind of does. So people are her slide all the time. It only takes a few bold ones to go after Lisa. Brandy was one of them. You see what happened. She slapped the hell out of her, and you see she ain't here this season. Other women, they just, you know, leave because they can't put up with it anymore. But they basically ask Kyle, like, do you know Lisa the Leak stories? And she's been accused of it before. Lisa Rinna just straight up snitched on her, talking about, look, a couple of years ago, she told me if I wanted to leak a story, how to do it. So if she told me how to do it, that means she's obviously done it before. Catch. So Lisa and this Blizzard dude, they definitely had a plan to set Teddy up. Now, here's the thing that really got Lisa Vanderpump caught. If you didn't know about the situation, you never knew anything, how it got out there, how were you able to call Dorit and tell her Teddy knows? If anything, of all the whole story that you told Dorit, the only thing that you could tell Dorit was Teddy knows about the dog. So for sure, she was planting that seed with Dorit, because once it got out, Dorit's obvious first assumption was going to be Teddy told the story. With everything pointed back to Lisa, there's nothing Kyle can do for her anymore, especially the fact that, you know, Lisa's not copping to it. Kyle went over there to warn her. Lisa called her off, basically a bitch, and like told her to leave. She wanted her, you know, just say, look, this is what happened. This all would have ended a lot quicker had Lisa just said, look, I did this because I was mad, I'm sorry. But no, she is going to Thelma and Louise's, and go over the cliff and ride it till the wheels fall off, because she ain't got nothing else to do. Because once she admits that she lied, everybody's going to know she's a liar, and she doesn't want that. She doesn't want to be seen as a person who purposely attacks people. So she's not going to allow that to happen. Kyle leaves, and Ken was basically like, you threw away a 12-year friendship. But no, I mean, let's be honest, Kyle has really been the one keeping that friendship afloat, because had Lisa really not had a good friend to Kyle, like, a lot of people would have dumped Vanderpump at this point, the way that she treats Kyle. She always wants to find a way to go after her, always wants to find a way to be mad at her about something petty. The type of friendship that Kyle and Lisa have is quite odd. Lisa likes to make sure that she's kind of the top of the duo. It's a very uneven friendship. Lisa, she basically likes to let people know, like remind them that if I did something for you, you owe me. Like, that's the type of person that she is. She's definitely got caught out for shit in the past, but she could just, there's never just have been a solid evidence against Lisa. When the previous season, when the Yolanda Munchausen thing happened, Lisa was all up in that, had everything to say, but then all the fallback just went on Kyle and Lisa Rinna. And then when they were in Dubai and she got called out, Kyle straight up like froze and was like, I'm not going to tell on Lisa. Like, what the hell, Kyle? Come on now. But she's learning her lesson finally, and I'm glad, because Lisa, you are like the typical American white woman who pokes, get dotted in the eye, and then be like, oh, you hit me. Why did you do that to me? Like, come on. You the same Peppermint Patty, they be calling 911 over some dumb shit. Like, this has got to go. You have got to go. Your reign has ended, and it is over for you. We gotta stay tuned for the next episode, because it's gonna get a lot more serious. I'm pretty sure a lot more information is gonna come out. So this season for sure is lit. Thank you guys for watching this TV review. I'm gonna be doing some more. I think I'm gonna start with Married to Medicine in LA, so stay tuned for that. This has been your girl Gigi. Y'all gonna catch me on the flip side. Deuces.